الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض، وله الحمد في الآخرة، وهو الحكيم الخبير. يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها، وهو الرحيم الغفور. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، سبحانه إله قادر عظيم، خلق هذا الكون بأسره، بمن فيه وما فيه، بما نعلم وما لا نعلم، بما نبصر وما لا نبصر، من غير أن يكون معه شريك في الملك. فينبغي أن نعبده سبحانه وألا نشرك به شيئا، إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ إلينا الرسالة وأدى إلينا الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، وتركنا صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي العربي المبارك، اللهم صلي عليه وسلم صلاة وسلاما يتجددان ما تجدد الليل والنهار. ثم أما بعد، My dear respected brothers, رمضان مبارك for all of you and for every Muslim in the world. الحمد لله رب العالمين who gave us the opportunity to attend Ramadan. It's a great نعمة, great gift of Allah سبحانه وتعالى for anyone attending this great month of Ramadan. Allah سبحانه وتعالى made this month Ramadan the best among the other months of the year, the best month. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in Ramadan a lot of treasures for Muslim ummah to get as much as you can during this great month of Ramadan. And to know or just to imagine how great is the month of Ramadan, let's study one hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu. Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu said, كان أخواني من بلي جاء فأسلما عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Two brothers from one tribe, its name Bali, very far from Al-Madinah. They came together and they embraced Islam at the same time. So one of them, he was very active in ibadah. His ibadat is more active than his brother. And that first brother, he passed away during fighting the enemies of Islam. He became shaheed. While the other brother passed away normally 1 year later. One Sahabi, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, رضي الله عنه, one of the 10 Sahaba, getting the news they will be from the people of Jannah. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say, whoever wants to see a shaheed walking, he has to look to Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, shaheed. And subhanallah, he became shaheed. But many years after the saying of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Talha ibn Ubaidillah, he saw in his dream that he went to heaven and went to in front of the gate of Jannah. And then he saw the second brother admitted to Jannah before Shaheed. The second brother who passed away normal, not Shaheed, he admitted to Jannah before Shaheed. Then after some time, the Shaheed admitted to Jannah after his brother. In one narration of this hadith, Talha رضي الله عنه said, the destination between the first brother and the second brother, like the destination from earth to heaven, very far. After that, Talha رضي الله عنه heard some voice coming from Jannah saying to him, go back, it's not your time. So Talha رضي الله عنه, after seeing this ru'ya, this dream, he shocked to see a person who passed away normally admitted to Jannah before Shaheed. Even his brother Shaheed, he was more active in ibadat than the second one. Talha رضي الله عنه started to tell the dream to the other Sahaba. And the dream came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Someone told him about the dream of Talha radiallahu anhu. And dream, brothers, dream, or the good dream, is one message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to a person regarding something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving the dream as a message to a person to show him something he in need to know. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith sahih, in sahih Muslim, the dream or the good dream is one part of 46 parts of prophethood. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before receiving the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before meeting with Jibreel alayhi salam first time, he used to see dreams, and the dreams came in real, came fact. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited Talha ibn Ubaidillah radiallahu anhu, asked him about the dream and said to Talha, why you are surprising? What surprised you, Talha, from this dream? He said, Ya Rasulallah, I surprised how come the second brother who passed away normally not shaheed admitted to Jannah before shaheed. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified the reason by saying, Talha, the second brother attended one Ramadan more than the first brother, the shaheed. Attending Ramadan, one Ramadan more than his brother. This sentence of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam showing us how Ramadan is a very great month. And for a person attending one Ramadan can be superior than other person who passed away before him. Even the other brother was shaheed, but attending Ramadan and doing the duties you have to do in Ramadan, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting your Ramadan, it will making you going faster than other person who passed away before Ramadan. That's why at the beginning I said Alhamdulillah who give us the opportunity to attend Ramadan, because you don't know next Ramadan you will be alive or not. And you are lucky this Ramadan to attend Ramadan while some other Muslim passed away before Ramadan. So the one who gave you this opportunity to attend Ramadan is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you have to be very thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving you this chance by attending one Ramadan. So attending Ramadan is a great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to everyone. And what we have to do is to do our best to be more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the great things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in Ramadan, which came in the hadith of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when the first night of Ramadan comes, look, from the first night, even before the day, the first night of Ramadan, like the night of Wednesday, because Ramadan started in Japan on Thursday. So from the night of Wednesday, according to this hadith, when the first night of Ramadan comes, صفضت الشياطين. The shayateen are chained, not to disturb people, not to disturb the Muslim people of doing the good deeds and increasing their good deeds in Ramadan. And all the gates of Jahannam are locked, and there is no one gate will be open during Ramadan. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showing us the position of Ramadan. In Ramadan only, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala locked all the gates of Jahannam, and no one gate will be open in Ramadan at all. This only in Ramadan. Only in Ramadan. And the gates of Jannah, paradise, are all open. All. How many gates of Jannah? Eight gates. All of them open, and no one of them will be locked in Ramadan. It has a meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inviting the Muslim people to do deeds which making them allowed to admit to Jannah. The Jannah is open. All the gates are open for you. All the gates of Jahannam are locked. So all the shayateen are chained. So everything is easy for you to be more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a call coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to people saying, O who have a desire for good deeds, increase it. And all who having desires for bad deeds, stop it. Then the last part of the hadith, وَلِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ عُتَقَى مِنَ النَّارِ. In every night of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving freedom from Jahannam to some people. So every night in this great month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving guarantee for some people not to go into Jahannam at all in every night of Ramadan. And in another narration of this hadith, at the last night of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving freedom for people from Jahannam similar to the number of the people from the beginning of Ramadan until the end. This will be the last night of Ramadan. What are the good deeds we can do in Ramadan. There are many, many of the good deeds you can do. Of course, number one, fasting Ramadan in the proper way. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith narrated by Abu Huraira also, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasted the month of Ramadan in out of faith and hoping to get the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of his previous sins will be forgiven. Fasting Ramadan, not like some people thinking that fasting just we stop eating and drinking from Fajr to Maghrib. The true Siyam is to make the whole body fasting, not only stomach fasting. The real Siyam of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make the whole body fasting. Your tongue fasting, not to say anything bad, not to do ghiba, not to do namima, not to abuse. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if someone tries to drive you for fighting or for saying some abusing, say to him, I am fasting, and don't go with him. Don't allow anyone to break your fasting by doing something by your tongue which is not allowed for fasting people. To make the tongue fasting, to make the eyes fasting, not to look to haram. To make the ear fasting, not to listen to any haram. To make the your feet fasting, not to go to any place of haram. Your hands, every part in your body have to fast. This is the true fasting. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, whoever not stop fake words in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need his fasting. His fasting not accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why, brothers? Because Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it as a training month for Muslim people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need your fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need to suffer you by stopping drinking and eating and enjoying your life during the day of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just wants us to train ourselves in Ramadan. So when a Muslim person giving the Siyam according to the Islamic way, according to the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will make the whole body fasting. And when he do it for 1 month, training his nafs, that after Ramadan, you will continue in the same way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showing you the way how to train yourself in Ramadan. So fasting in Ramadan, of course, very important. Al-Quran in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Al-Quran in Ramadan. And in Laylat al-Qadr, a special night, Laylat al-Qadr, And in the hadith narrated by Wa'ila, Wa'ila ibn al-Asqa' radiyallahu anhu, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the sheets of Ibrahim alayhi salam, suhuf Ibrahim alayhi salam, in the first day of Ramadan. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choosing Ramadan for revealing some of the holy books like suhuf Ibrahim alayhi salam. It was in the first day of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Tawrat to the Prophet Musa alayhi salam after 6 days of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Injil to Isa alayhi salam 13th of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Zabur to Dawood alayhi salam 18th of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Al-Quran Al-Kareem 24th of Ramadan. 24th of Ramadan. When we say 24th of Ramadan, maybe some people will surprising saying, how come 24? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr, and laylatul qadr coming in the odd nights, not 24. This is the importance of ulama in Islam to show you and explain to you the real meaning, which you cannot understand by yourself. If you get the hadith by yourself, you will misunderstand this 24 of Ramadan. So one great scholar of hadith, Imam Al-Hulaymi, rahmahullah, he said, when he explained the meaning of this part in the hadith, he said it was the night of 25th of Ramadan. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said 24. 24 means the night of 25th of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Al-Quran Al-Kareem at that night. Of course, we will talk about the revelation of Al-Quran Al-Kareem in another time. So in Ramadan, it's a good opportunity for us, for Muslim people, to recite Al-Quran Al-Kareem as much as you can. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum and the Tabi'een and the greatest scholars of Islam, when Ramadan comes, they used to stop all activities they used to do in the other times. They used to make ta'aleem, teaching other people, but when Ramadan comes, they stopped everything. Why it stopped? Because they became more busy with reciting Al-Quran Al-Kareem. So reciting Al-Quran Al-Kareem in Ramadan, one of the good deeds for a Muslim to do, inshallah. And minimum to make one khatm of Al-Quran Al-Kareem during Ramadan. I am saying minimum to do one khatm of Al-Quran Al-Kareem during Ramadan time. Some great people can do more. Some people can make two times, three times, four times, according to their efforts. This one of the best of the good deeds you can do in Ramadan, to make yourself busy with Al-Quran Al-Kareem, reciting Al-Quran as much as you can during Ramadan. Sadaqat, one of the great deeds we can do in the great month of Ramadan and increasing it in this great month of Ramadan. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu said, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was the most generous person. And he used to be more generous in Ramadan, increasing the sadaqat in Ramadan. This one of the good deeds we can do in this great month of Ramadan. A lot of the good deeds we can do in Ramadan, any of the good deeds you do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with pure niyyah, it will be recommended to increase it in Ramadan. And be sure that the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you in Ramadan will not be the same for other days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reward of Ramadan will be special for the Muslim people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to increase our good deeds in this great month of Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العلي العظيم لي ولكم. توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه، فالتائب حبيب الرحمن والتائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تمسك بسنته وعمل بشريعته إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، one also of the good deeds recommended in Ramadan is feeding a fasting people. To feed fasting person, this also one of the very great deeds you can do in Ramadan. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever feeds a fasting person, he will get the same reward of him. So when you offer some iftar for fasting person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by your great deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you the same thawab, the same reward of that fasting person. So all the ways of the good deeds are open in Ramadan. Try to get as much as you can, because as I said at the beginning, it's opportunity for us, alhamdulillah, to attend this Ramadan, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept and to help us in this great month of Ramadan. Allahumma inna nas'aluka fi hadha al-yawm al-mubarak alla tad'a lana fihi dhanban illa ghafartah, wala 'ayban illa satartah, wala maridan illa shafaytah, ولا غائبا إلا رددته، ولا ضالا إلا هديته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا يسرتها وأعنتنا عليها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لك الحمد أن بلغتنا رمضان، اللهم لك الحمد أن بلغتنا رمضان، اللهم لك الحمد أن بلغتنا رمضان. اللهم أعنا فيه على فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وحب المساكين. اللهم لا تخرجنا من رمضان إلا وقد غفرت لنا ذنوبنا وكفرت عنا سيئاتنا وأعتقت رقابنا من النار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر واجعلنا من أهلها، اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر واجعلنا من أهلها، اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر واجعلنا من أهلها. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. وصلى الله تعالى وسلم على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.